Well, good morning, everybody. Great to see a large, cheerful crowd here this morning. We welcome you to True North, both everyone that here is here in person and those that will be joining online later. We look forward to seeing how God moves in this service this morning, especially look forward to the baptism a little later on. I know everyone's excited about that. Let's begin our service here with just a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, God, we just thank you so much, God, that we can just come to this place to gather in your name, to worship you as a fellowship of believers, Lord. We thank you so much, dear God, that you, even during these times, that we can see you moving in our midst, moving in our church, dear Lord. Thank you so much that you are speaking to hearts and that we get to celebrate with this family in the waters of baptism. God, we're so excited to just see the growth in the church and be able to see you move. And you are still in the soul-saving business. We just pray that these words of worship would just be pleasing to your ear, dear God. Just be with us and surround us with your presence this morning. Yes, in your name, amen. Pastor Mike.
Thank you, worship team. Just as we come this morning, it's just great to be here and to celebrate on this day. It's a little bit different for us as we try to figure out how to do a baptism in COVID and all that sort of stuff, and to celebrate with Jenna and Dennis and their family. And so this morning, I'm just going to give a little bit of the full sermon. So if you really want the full sermon, you can stay for the second service as well. And thanks for laughing. Yeah, all right. Some of you hit your remote car starter to get your car running there. Anyway, but as I was preparing this day for the family, I preached on these verses not too long ago. I can't remember exactly when, but they were just laid on my heart again, and it's in Isaiah 43, verses 18 and 19. And these words are just fantastic, I think, for today as we celebrate baptism, as we celebrate with a family dedication as well. And the prophet writes these words. You know, forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up, do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. And I just love these verses. You know, the first is, you know, forget the former things, the prophet is saying, the Lord is saying to the nation of Israel, you know, forget those things that are behind you and to begin to focus on the things that are before you, that God is doing a new thing. And we certainly celebrate new life today in Jesus. And we start almost a fresh chapter in your journey, in your spiritual journey. And those words that the Lord is making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. You know, he's providing a way. He's providing direction. And that idea of streams in the wasteland. You think this summer in our communities with the near drought conditions that we had and how low that river was. And when we saw the harvest taking place, you could see plumes of dust over the landscape. You know, it was a dry and the land was thirsty. And now to see the river full and wells are coming to life again and all those sorts of things, you think of how much relief that can bring us in the community in which we live in a farming community. And here's the Lord saying to them, you know, I'm going to bring forth that new life that only I can bring and clear a path in the wilderness. And so this morning, just as I was thinking of those things, and as Jenna and Dennis are going to be following the Lord in the waters of baptism, I just love this whole concept of new, right? That is what Jesus brings. I was on a Zoom meeting, I guess, with other pastors from across Atlantic Canada. We had a pastor on there with us by the name of J.R. Briggs from down in the States. And he was talking about how in this climate in which we are in with COVID-19 throughout the world, that, you know, they're looking for a vaccine, they're looking for a cure and all that sort of stuff. Well, he is saying, you know, really it is a story for what is happening in the hearts of humanity. We have a virus of sin. And the vaccine is Jesus. He's the only one that can take that away completely and fully. And we celebrate that today as Jenna and Dennis have given their heart to the Lord and want to follow him in the waters of baptism. And we hear those words, forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. And so as Dustin is going to come and have a family dedication for them, and then as we prepare for the baptismal service as well, may we just as a church celebrate, as we looked at last week, you know, the power of God is still at work. Calling Dustin to come at this time.
I was still in the middle of doing my count to see how many people we crammed in here this morning. It is good to be here this morning and to worship together. As we come together, I'm so excited to look around and see a lot of our families here and to come alongside of you guys as well and to support you as you grow and you learn and you discover and you step out and show the community what it is that God is doing in your lives. So before I get to that, I'm just going to make an announcement, I think. I think I only have one this week, and that is that next Sunday we will be starting back up our children's ministries here at the church to help families come alongside families in our community and help them to teach their children. And so that will be in the 10:30 service downstairs. Of course, we are still in a public building, so masks required. We do currently, it'll be grade 3 or age 3 to grade 5. No nursery yet because we can't figure that out yet, but we'll get there someday. So that's just a fun little announcement for you. Why don't you guys come on up? So we have, I'm running into things. Come on over here to the middle so that we can make sure that everyone can see. So this morning we have Elliot. Elliot, can you give a wave? Yeah, you can do that. And Brooke. Excellent. And this morning you two are going to be baptized, and through your journey the last few months and years as you've been attending here, I'm just sharing a little of your story with the church, hearing about who God is, understanding a little more, and especially through the pandemic, God has been working in your life, correct, and doing some great and amazing things and helping you two through a lot of things that you've been experiencing and helping you as a family to grow together. And so this morning, as they were stepping out in faith as a couple, they also said, you know what, we would like to take this moment to recognize our children and to recognize. And so we call this sometimes a children's dedication, but really it's a family dedication. It's a recognition that you as a couple are wanting and desiring to raise Elliot and Brooke to know and love God. It's a recognition that we as a church will support you in that, to help you in that, and to see that as well. And so, I just have one question for you, really. Is it your intention, do you desire to raise your children to know and to love Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior?
It is.
Absolutely fantastic. That is why we are here. And so this morning, let us pray together, pray over this family. Father God, we are so thankful for the work that you have been doing. We are so thankful for the way that you have been working in their lives throughout the last few months and years. Lord God, I pray that as they raise these children, Lord God, that as Elliot and Brooke are brought up, Lord God, that we as a church would be here to support. But Lord God, that their parents would instill in them your values, that they would help them to realize your love and the way that you do great and mighty works. Lord God, may Elliot and Brooke know how wide, how deep your love is for them. Lord God, in the difficult days as a family, may they turn to you in prayer. Lord God, in the great days, may they recognize and give you thanksgiving and joyous shouts of praise. Lord God, may you be with this family every day, guiding, directing, and helping them to love you even more. In your name, amen. So now I'm going to ask the worship team to come up, and we're going to join in worship as you guys go and prepare for water. So will you join us in worship this morning?
Stone.
Worship team for that. Now I just have to sneak back here for a second. Excellent. So Jenna is going to be baptized first, and so with baptisms here, we ask the candidates if they would like to have someone pray over them before they are baptized, and so Jenna has asked that her stepfather, John, be that person. Where did you say the sanitizer stuff was?
Oh, it's over on the table.
Oh, sorry. We have a new step to do everything. We're cleaning some some souls. Well, they've been cleaned. But we also now need to clean microphones as we pass them from person to person. So, John, if you want to come up, and I'll sanitize and hand this over to you as you pray for your daughter-in-law.
Okay.
Your stepdaughter. Get these rolls right here.
She's my daughter.
There you go.
Can I take this off?
Yes, you can.
Okay. So, good morning, man. It's good to be back in church. It's been way too long. It's great to see you all this morning. So Jenna asked me to pray this morning. Before I do that, I hope you don't mind, just like to say a few words. I can't talk about Jenna's journey, only she can do that, but there are a couple of things that stand out to me. And I guess the first thing I'd like to say is the words last week of the power of God is still at work. It really resonated with me. I see it every day when I step out of my back porch and look at creation, and I see the power of God. And now I see what the power of God does in individual lives, and what an awesome contrast between, you know, everything and then us as individuals, how he wants us to be blessed and to serve him. I'm so thankful that we have pastors that preach the gospel message here on Sundays, that they not only equip the church to live their faith, but also bring the truth of the gospel down to the place where the lost can actually understand it and receive it. So I'm really thankful for that. So finally, it's funny where God's word will take you. When I learned of the decision that Jen and Dennis have made and the baptism today, one of the first places I came to was 1 Peter chapter 4, where Peter says, you know, baptism is a promise of a good conscience toward God. The next day, I was in Deuteronomy 13:4, where, you know, the command is we're instructed to obey God's commands and to serve him. And for me, it just sort of connected some dots. I'm very honored to be part of this morning. So I guess, too, I'd like to share, I'm not really trying to preach here, but I would like to share just a couple of snippets of Jenna's story. Back to the truth of God's word, one of the things that resonated with Jenna was the sermon not too long ago where the children of Israel marched around Jericho as commanded by God, and the walls came crumbling down. You know, Jenna, like most of us, this past year or so has been difficult at times, but in the hour that message resonated with Jenna. In the hour of her decision and in a time of distress, she called out to the Lord. He answered her, and her walls started to come tumbling down. So I just praise God for how things work together. Okay. So I'd like to pray. Let's pray. Lord, let us not lose sight of why we're here. We're here because of Jesus. We're here because the awesome power of God is still at work, and you're calling people to yourself. And oftentimes it occurs in times of difficulty, either, you know, circumstances beyond our control, and sometimes it's difficulty in our own lives. But I'm so thankful for Jenna. Paula and I have seen the transformation over the past year or two, and we have seen the journey that she has been on, and we are so thankful that she's put her trust in you. So my prayer for Jenna is that as she moves forward and starts to work out her faith, that she look to your word, call on your name, and continue to trust in you, and you will provide what Jenna needs on a daily basis. And we thank you for that. So just thank you again. We are so blessed to be here today. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
All right, John, you can stay right up here. And I'm going to get, actually, Paula, if you will come up as well with the kids. You guys can come on up and you can get a little front row view. How about that as a family? I'm just going to make sure. Caleb, if they stand here, are they in the shot or like they in the way? Okay. You guys come on. Yeah. Okay. You can stay right over there. That's, I guess. Wait, hold up. I'm going to move you right to here, actually. I know we're getting things, we're doing it as we go here, but that way people can, behind you can still see and you guys can get a good view here this morning. All right, go ahead, Mike. Do your thing.
Baptism is an outward expression of an inward and spiritual truth that Jesus has saved Jenna of her sin and given her an eternal hope. Jenna, have you asked Jesus to save you from your sin, and do you seek to follow him all the days of your life?
I have, and I will.
Upon your profession of faith, I baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Come on down, Dennis. As Dennis was sharing his story as well about what the Lord has done in his life, a very important mentor for Dennis is Alex Muir, and they have journeyed together over the past couple of years, and Alex isn't able to be here this morning, but he sent along some words for Dennis, so I wanted to share them and to share a prayer that Alex has wrote as well. Dennis, on this very special occasion, I'm sorry not to be able to be in attendance. Today, as you enter the waters of baptism, you are proclaiming the greatest message ever voiced. Your testimony of accepting Jesus' death, his burial, and his resurrection being sufficient to pay the debt for your sin in demonstrating it publicly. Dennis, I trust today that you will experience God's richest blessing in your life, that you will follow him wholeheartedly, trusting him in the difficult times and always rejoicing as he is by your side. Let us pray together. Dear Lord, thank you for Dennis's life and for the special event as he declares his trust in you for his salvation. May he grow in his faith as he walks with you, and may he realize that you desire your best for him as a son, as a man, as a husband, as a father, and that you will always be beside him no matter his circumstances. Bless him today in Jesus' name. Amen. Dennis, have you asked Jesus to save you from your sin, and do you seek to follow him all the days of your life?
Yes.
Upon your profession of faith,
just move a little bit this way.
I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And together we recognize the great thing of baptism is that it's something that we all journey through together. We are all invited into the waters of baptism. We all recognize the significance. And so baptism is a great thing because it reminds us of the commitment that we each individually have made to God, but also corporately as a church, what we recognize and stand for. And so this morning, I'm going to ask the worship team to come and lead us out as we worship corporately together. Uh.
Amen. Are you excited this morning? How could you not be after that? All right, we'll give you a chance to prove it here, and we'll say no, happy day.
Maybe. I'm going to try and wear in-ears and a mask at the same time. Sorry. All right.
Greatest day in history. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Look across the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. Jesus, you are. In this joy, perfect peace. Nothing pain, finally we'll see. Celebrate, Jesus is alive.
God, we are so thankful for your Holy Spirit that is continuing to work in our lives to transform and change us more into your image. Father God, we are so thankful for that day on the cross that you took our sins. Lord God, that we no longer have to be ashamed or condemned, Lord God, because we are free in you. Lord God, thank you for the testimony of what you are doing this morning. Lord God, thank you for Jenna and Dennis and the way that you are working in their lives. Lord God, I pray that you continue to work in our community. In your name, amen.